Okay. But first of all, I would like to tell you that today we are going to talk about the next topic. That is also important, but maybe less than a stack that we have already studied last week. But today I will talk about Q, right? And the content today will be start from the definition of Q, and then as I told you, right, the Q and stack are very similar, right? So we can represent it by using array or linked list, right? So today we will go into detail about how can we represent the queue, right? By using array and linked list, and we will go focus on the linked list, and then I will talk about the type of queues, and the last one will be the application of queues, right, in the real world applications, right, that you might know. So first of all, I have to start from the application or the obvious situation that you will use queue, right? For the first example, as you can see this, right? Okay, if you go to the hospital, right? And if you want to see the doctor, right? So what you have to do is you have to register or book or reserve the time schedule for the doctor. And then you have to wait for the queue, right? When you have the slot schedule, right, that you have reserved to see the doctor, but you need to stay in the queue as well. And the next example that is quite familiar to you, that is the situation that you are waiting for the bus, right? And you have to wait. I'm not sure whether in Thailand we can have this kind of the queue like this, but in other countries they will have to stay in queue, as well as in the escalator, right? Need to be in queue as well. Okay, this is some kinds of the queue that you can see these applications in your real world applications. But thinking about as you are the computer engineers, as you are the software engineers, you may have to think about queue as well, right? You may use queue in the situation that you have to represent the operating system. If you have 8 core processors, right? And you may have to dedicate one CPU to be the manager, and then 7 remaining CPUs, right? You have to, the manager, the CPU manager, we have to handle the queue, right? And the schedule for the tasks, right? That to be executed in the CPU. Okay, this is a kind of queue or many examples. I will talk about this at the end of this presentation. Okay, first of all, I would like to introduce the definition of queue, right? Queue. From in all these examples, you see that the element at the first position is served first. Okay, queue is different from the stack, right? If you could remember when we talk about the stack, right? And then when you put something in the stack, right? This one will be, okay, A. And then push B into the stack. And then C, and then D, right? Which process will be executed first according to the example? The one that you pop out of the stack, right? This is a stack representation, right? It could be array or linked list, but which one will be served first? When you talk about the stack, right? Stack will be a kind of LIFO, right? Do you remember LIFO? Last in, first out. So the first, okay, according to this example, D will be processed first. And then when D is popped up, right, then C will be executed letter and then B and then A, right? This is a way that stack implementation performs. Okay, but for the case of Q, right? Q as its name, right? The manner of the queue will be FIFO. FIFO means first in, first out. First come, first serve. Sometimes you can say it is first comes, first served, first served. Okay, this is common. So a queue is a kind of a FIFO data structure in which the element that is inserted first is the first one to be taken out. Right, the first one insert first, and then it will be the first one to be executed. So this is the process of a queue, right? The elements in a queue are added at one end called it rear, and removed from the other end called it front. For example, we can have front here, right? Front here, and then A will be front. And then the next one, okay, I'm trying to represent it in terms of the linked list. And then C like this. Where is rear? According to the queue, which element will be the rear pointer points? C, right? Rear. Am I right? Okay, so the elements in a queue are added at the one end called rear and removed from the other end called front. Front will be removed first. Okay. So the next element that's going to be inserted in this queue will be D. So D will be inserted at rear, right? At rear. So we will change the pointer to D. D will be the last element of the queue. So this is what queue does. Queues can be implemented by using either arrays or ring list. Okay. This is quite common. If you implement it by using array, it will be easier than linked list. But if you use maybe the higher programming languages, for example, Java or Python, you don't have to think about the lower level of the implementation. You can just simply use the insert or delete function. And the details of the implementation can be ignored. So you don't have to think about that. But when you write C program, you have to handle the array or linked list. And if you try to handle by using linked list, you may have to use the pointers and you may have to deal with the pointers that is quite tedious. Understand that you can say, why do we have to study about linked list or array? That is quite difficult. Even we have the Java programming, but what I'm trying to say is that if you know C as your first programming language, you can implement anything, any application in the world. For example, operating system. If you want to develop operating system, C programming has to be concerned. You have to implement it by C. If you could remember 2 or 3 years ago, right, when Huawei was rejected from United States of America, right, and Huawei cannot use Google or even for the Android as well. So by the time Chinese Huawei companies try to recruit 800 OS programmers by that time, right? Just only the computer scientists or computer engineers who can write program in C programming in order to develop its own mobile operating system, right? But I don't, they don't have to worry about the Android, right? And right now, I think Huawei has been accomplished for develop its own operating system, right? I'm not sure about the name, but I think we are going to have iOS, Android, and another one. Harmony OS, that's right. Thank you, Pompanot. Harmony OS, that's right. Mm-hmm. This is another kind of mobile operating system. And once Huawei can develop this kind of operating system and the technology for the camera or even for the chip's design, I think the, how can I say, the war of mobile phones will be very still based on Android though. Uh-huh. Still based on Android, yes. Now it's, but it's going to be, okay, they have to develop following the Android, right? Who knows? Okay, so maybe I'm trying to tell you the inspiration of studying C programming, but I understand that it's quite difficult. But for my opinion, I still suggest you to try to study or try to practice C programming. Okay. Okay, the next one. Okay, this is the step implement. Mm-hmm. That. Oops, maybe I forget to delete the stack implementation here. Okay. Oh, then the next topic that I will talk today is the array representation of Q, right? Q is very easy to represent Q by using array, right? Linear array, right? And as I just told you that. For a queue, right, you have to define two pointers. The first one is front, right? Front will represent the front. Rear will represent rear. What does it mean? The front will represent the first one, right? The first item or the first element in the queue. And this one is going to be removed first, right? Because it is on the first position, right? So in this array, right, 12 will be the first to be first come first serve, right? And then next to 9, 7, 18, 14, and the rear, that is at the end of this queue will be 36. But if you have one more element that will be inserted to this queue, right, it's going to reinsert into the 7 position at index 6. Okay, index 6, 7th position, right? So, okay, so from this example, right, if you want to insert 45 into this queue, right? So rear will point to 5, right? Index 5. So if you want to insert the next one, so you have to move rear to the sixth one, to the sixth index, and then copy 45 into this array. And that's all. This is the insertion for the queue. But if you want to take the first element from the queue, delete the first element, so this one will be disappeared, and then the next step or the next pointer font will point to the next array, that is index 1. Okay, font will move from here to here. Okay, do you get the point? So this is quite easy if you understand SATA, right? Q is very easy, right? As it name, right? Q is as it name, right? You will have to put the new element to rear, to the end of Q, but you have to remove the first element from the queue, right? Because of FIFO, first in, first out manner. And if you talk about the operation on queue, right, we have, okay, actually we have three basic one, right? Insert, delete, and peek, right? But I forget to put the peek here. Okay, peek is to get the first element from the queue, right? Just only the value, right, of the first element in the queue. But I read to you all to focus only the insert and delete elements from the queue. Okay, when you want to insert an element to the queue, you have to insert to the rear. But if you want to delete, you have to delete from the front. Okay, and you have to take care of the index of front and rear. This is the easiest one, right? You need to implement queue by using array, right? This algorithm is an inserting algorithm. We want to insert an element in a queue, right? But this one is array, right? So the first step, if rear is equal to max minus one, max minus one will be the last element of the array, right? When we declare array of three elements, right, this one is 0, 1, and 2. 2 is equal to max, which is 3 minus 1, right? This is max minus 1. This is the rear. If rear is pointed to this location, so you cannot insert element right after this one because this one is the last element. Okay, once again, right, if rear is equal to max minus one in case like this, right, three minus one is two. Index two, right, if rear is pointed to index two, so it's not possible to put anything to this location or this storage. So what you have to do is write overflow and then go to step four. Go to step four, then this is the exit, and that's all. Okay, this is just a simple one, right? We are going to develop a new one that is better than this, but in this one, in this way, you have just to check for the front and rear. And okay, if front is equal to minus one and rear is equal to minus one. So this is a kind of initialization initialization of the algorithm, right? So you have to set front to rear, front and rear to zero. Okay, so that's mean front and rear will be, suppose we have four elements and front and rear will be pointed to the same point. Okay, normally it is point to minus one, minus one, minus one, minus one is here, rear and front point to here. And then if you are going to insert a new element once the queue is empty. In this case, step two, it means that the queue is empty. When the queue is empty, front is equal to minus one and rear is equal to minus one. Okay, please note it here. Write T stars. Once you have known that queue is empty now, so you have to set the element set the pointer front and rear to be zero, or they will point to zero element. Okay, and then queue rear now is zero, right? Queue rear is equal to num. Num is an element that you are going to insert into this queue. Okay, because this one, this operation is insert, right? This function is insert. You want to insert num to the queue, right? So in this way, when you have the situation that this is the first element to be inserted, then you set the pointer to zero and then insert num into the queue zero. Okay, otherwise you have to step increment rear by one, right? Rear plus increment rear by one, and then do the same thing, right? Set step three, right? That is set queue rear is equal to num. It means that you assign num to the queue rear. supposed to have array queue rear, right? The first num, right, one will be put when this one is zero. And then once you want to insert two into this queue, so now front and rear is equal to zero. And then you have to increase rear by one. So you can be one, the num will be inserted into this element, right? Q1 is equal to two, right? That is to place two into this queue at indexed one, okay? And then that's all, exit. Okay, I hope you can follow my explanation here, right? And the next one will be the, if you want to implement this function is insert operation to a C program function, right? First of all, you may have to, you want to insert something, right? Insert num, right? And then enter the number to be inserted into the queue, and then you get second F num, right? If rear is equal to max minus one, you can see from this algorithm, right? If rear is equal to max minus one, what shall we do? Printed overflow. This one, overflow. Okay, overflow. And else, if else, right? Else, you have to check if front is equal to minus one and rear is equal to minus one. In this case, it's the case that the queue is empty, right? Do you remember? Queue is empty, right? When front is equal to minus one and rear is equal to minus one. So you have to initialize front and rear to zero. Is it syntactically correct in C programming? Do you think compiler will pass this statement or not? Anyone in this room can answer this question? Is it compilation error or it is can be compilable? Pithyapa said it's a no. Yes. Are you all still with me? Oh, I think it can be compiled, but it won't. Have result 21. Okay. Anyone else? Let me drink some water. What is the question? The question is it possible for C compiler to compile this statement? Okay, I would say that it is compilable. Okay, it is compilable and there is no syntax error as well, right? This way, right? This is an assignment of zero to rear, which is a variable. And rear is going to be a variable that will be assigned to front as well. So you can write A is equal to B equal to C equal to one. But everyone will be assigned to one. And else, rear plus plus, right? And else, rear plus plus, and then Curia is equal to num, or you can assign num to curia. That is the current position of the ria element in the queue. Okay, so this is very simple. That we, if you want to insert an argument or insert an element into the queue, right? So this, you can use this algorithm in order to insert something num into the queue. For the case of delete an element, where if you use delete operation in queue, right, which position will be deleted? Which position will be deleted? So for the delete operation, right, you have to check for the underflow first. Underflow will be if font is equal to minus one. Okay, it means that there is nothing in this queue, or font is greater than real. Maybe this case, this situation is possible, right? When you, I don't know, maybe it's possible. So you have to write underflow. This is an error. This is an error. But else, if there is at least one element in queue, right? First of all, you have to get the value of the element in the queue where the font pointer points to. Okay, again, you are going to recall to get the value, and the value has to be stored in this variable while. And then where is it? From queue, right? Queue where the font pointer points to. Okay, that's why this is queue fonts. And then you have to step font, increment font index by one. And then you have to increment font index by one. For example, if you have A point to B, point to C, right? If you want to delete an element from the queue, you need to delete the first element. So first of all, you have to get the first element. Okay, font will point here, right? Font will point here, so A will be assigned to val. And then font will move one step further, right? To point to B, right? To point to B, and then this one. Actually, I cannot like link this, right? I have to write down it in terms of array, right? A, B, C, D, sorry. Okay, font point here. So once A has been assigned to val, right? Then font will point to B. And okay, in A, maybe A is still in the array, right? You don't have to delete F or put the buffer or dummy value for A, right? You don't have to, because you remove font from A to B. And that's all. But this is the way that we delete an element from the queue. Okay, in the C program, right? If you want to delete an element from queue, so you, first of all, you have to check for the underflow, and then, right, pin underflow, and then return minus one. And else, right, if it there is at least one value or one element in this queue, so first of all, you have to get the value of the queue at the index font and assign it to value. And then font plus, right? If font is greater than ria, right? Then you have to set font and ria to minus one. This means that the maximum of the queue has been used. So from this example, can you find any mistake or any invalid situation? Okay, if you don't see anything wrong, I will continue with the next one. That is a linked list presentation of Q. That I have already talked about this a bit, right? About the linked list representation of a Q. Why do we have to use linked list to implement Q? Anyone can answer this question? Because of the drawback of the array, right? If you represent the queue by using array, right? You need, as its name, right? When you use array, right? You have to fix the number of elements for your array. So you have to set it up to the possible maximum value that it could be, right? For example, if you allocate the space for 50 elements for the queue, right? But if you can use just only 20, 25 location, this is okay. But the problem is that half of the space will be waste, okay? That is not optimized, right? When we talk about the optimization of the space in the queue or the memory allocation, right? It would be not so good optimized. So in the case that you want to make it optimized or make it more efficient, right? For the array representation. So you may have to predict about the number of the elements, but in the real world application, you cannot do that, right? You can just simply use the possible maximum number in order to allocate the long or the contiguous elements in your memory. But in some special case, right, if you are dealing with a big data, right, in the future, right, you can implement your program and then you need to develop or to tackle with the big data, big number of data. So if you allocate the memory by using array, right? Array has to be contiguous elements. You cannot find the biggest number of the element like that. So you need to allocate the larger element or larger space, or you have to use it efficiently, and you need to reallocate if the allocated space is not enough. So in this drawbacks here, you need to use the linked list, right? As it name, right? Linked list, you have to use, in certain cases, you have to develop the dynamic allocation, not the static, like array, right? So in this case, right, you can use a linked list that will be more efficient, and it's going to be an efficient implementation if you cannot define the maximum size of the array or the storage, right? And in this case, the linked list representation is a good choice, but as it named, right, you have known that there is also the drawbacks of the linked list. What is that? When you use linked list, right, you have to reallocate the space all the time. And then sometimes you may have the overhead storage that you need to handle with the pointer to the next element. This is the overhead and consuming a lot of time. But when you trade off with the flexible and dynamic allocation, so that is worth enough, okay? So this is some trade off of the linked list and stack. That is why when I teach you, right, about the queue or the stack, right, I will show you both stack and linked list. And the concept, they are very similar, right? But the representation, only representation are different. When we talk about the link representation of a queue, right, the storage requirement of link list representation of a queue with an element is big O n, big O n. And the typical time requirement for operation is big O one, big O one, that is constant, right? In link queue, we in instead of saying link list representation of queues, like I will call it shortly a linked queue. A linked queue, every element has two parts. The first part is the data and another part is the address to the next element. That is common attributes of the linked list, okay? This is a linked queue, okay? And the operation of the linked queue is similar to the case of the array. Right, we also have two basic operation, insert and delete, okay? And we also have peak, right, as I told you, just told you to return the value of the first element of the queue. Okay, so for linked list, right, you have to insert the new node to the front. Oh, sorry, you have to insert the new node to the rear. Right, because it has to be a FIFO manner, first in, first out, last in, last out, last in, last out. But there is no LILO, okay? It's no LILO, okay. But last in, last out, right? Insert the new element. And okay, this is what the C implementation for the C program implementation for the insert operation, okay? So this one is insert, right? Insert function, right? You need to get the value structure queue, right? This is an address to queue, and you want to insert new value here, right? The queue. First of all, you need to define the link pointer and then allocate pointer by using malloc function, right? Size of structure node, and then return the address of this structure node to the pointer. Okay, this is the fixed step for the memory allocation for the linked list or the node, right, of the size structure node. And then pointer to data is assigned by val or value, right? The argument value will be assigned to the data, right? The data has been assigned into the new memory allocation for the structure node. In structure node, we have data and pointer, right? The link, the next. If Q point to front is equal to null, when Q point to front if Q point to front, right, then Q front point to this new pointer and Q rear to the new pointer. So this one is when there is nothing in this queue, right? If there is nothing to this queue, right, data value will be the first value, and then front will point to pointer, this pointer, PTR, Q for new pointer, Q rear, and for new point to this pointer. And then Q for next and Q rear next will point to now. Okay, this is the initialization. But if there is something in this queue, right? Q rear next will point to pointer. And Q rear will point to pointer, right? The current position, the current new pointer, right? Rear dot next will point to value, and Q dot rear reply to this pointer. And also curia next. Curia point to next, you point to now. Do you understand this one? Okay, I will repeat it again. Suppose you insert the new value. You need to insert first value, right? And font Andrea, you point to the first one, right? And then you insert the new one. You, first of all, you have to allocate pointer, right? And pointer will point to the new node. New node, suppose it will be C, B, right? And then this one is now, okay? So the next step will be pointer, data will be a value. We are value, so B will be here. And then because it's not now, it's not now, right? So we skip to else part, okay? So now, curia. Curia is here, right? Curia.next. Curia next will point to pointer. Curia next will point to, curia next is here, right? Curia next is here, point to pointer. Pointer, point to here. Curia, right? Curia. This is Ria, right? Ria next, point to where the pointer points to. Okay, this is the first step. The second step is curia. Curia now is still here. Curia now. We have to move curia, right? Curia, delete curia, and change it to point to pointer. Yeah, you can see that curia now point to pointer. When you set curia is equal to pointer, it means that the address of the pointer will be keep to Ria. Ria will keep the address, so the address of the pointer is here. Right, because the pointer is point to B. And then the last step, curia next, curia next, curia. This one is curia, right? Curia. Dot next, next is here. It's equal to now. Okay. You can just simply write it now. I use this notation to represent now. Okay, and this is a way that we insert a new element, a new value element to this link list, to this link queue. What will be the structure of queue? The structure of queue is the same. I think the structure of queue will not be the same as node. Queue will have two pointer, Ria and font, yes. Queue will have two pointers, Ria and font. Mm-hmm. And I think it will point to structure queue as well. Oh, structure queue, structure node. We have two kinds, right? Structure queue and structure node. Right, thank you, Siri Warakun. Mm-hmm. Structure queue is structure node. To font and structure node to Ria. Okay, I will stop. I have a break for 5 or 10 minutes and then we will come back again. Okay. I'm trying to rebroadcast my iPad. What's happened? Okay, I will continue with the next operation, that is delete the node from the queue, right? Similar to the case of the delete operation in array, right, for the queue, right? We can just simply use the, okay, for the deletion, you need to delete the front element from the queue, and then this one will be the list, right? And then you can point to the front. So in order to do this delete operation using C programming, you can use, okay, structure queue, right? This is the delete element. Delete from what? From this queue, right? Queue is a structure queue. Okay, so first of all, you need to define the pointer, right? This is a structure node. And then pointer variable here will be assigned by queue front, where the front pointed to. Okay, so when we have this one, pointer will point to the place that front pointed to. Okay, this is this statement. Then if front point to now, right, it means that this queue is empty. Okay, queue is empty. Okay, if queue is empty, you can say underflow. You cannot delete any node from this queue. Otherwise, else, right? Queue front point to next is this one, right? This one is queue front point to next. Okay, I will use this one. Queue front. Queue front point to next is this one. The pointer to one. This is queue front next. Okay. This one. We will assign this one to queue front. Queue front. Okay. Now, queue font will point to one. First, queue font point to here, right? But now, queue font point to here. Queue font point to where queue font next points to. Okay, then the value has been, okay, the value of data will be pointer is point to here, okay, the pink one, pointer will point to here, pointer will point to Q font, right, pointer is assigned to Q font, this one is Q font first. In ping link, firstly point to the first one, but after that queue font point to, firstly queue font point to this, but after queue font next, queue font will point to queue font next, queue font will point to queue font next, and then now we can access to the data that has been deleted by using pointer. Now pointer data is 9, so 9 will be printed out. 9 will be printed out, and then once you can print this, you have to free this pointer. Free this pointer means this one will be free. Now queue font will point to 1 like this. Okay, so it means that Q font will point to 1 like this. And then that's all. This is the step-by-step of delete operation using linked list or linked queue. Okay. This one is quite simple, okay, for the deletion. Okay, here we are. We have two topics left for today's class, right? The first one is the types of queue, right? When we talk about queue, right, you can implement it by using a simple queue, as I just told you, right, in either array representation or linked list representation. But for the, you can also have the many kinds of the queue data structure. Queue data structure can be classified into circular queue. Circular queue, deck, we call this, we pronounce this deck, and then priority queue, and then multiple queue, right? So today I will talk about circular queue in details. Mm-hmm. So first of all, I would like to introduce you to the circular queue. Sometimes like just only queue is not enough, because when you as it just ask you, right, is there any problem or is there any drawbacks for the queue that I have just implemented? I'll tell you, right? The drawbacks for the queue for the representation or the linked list representation is that if you have the maximum number of queue, suppose we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, when we have already finished 6 queue, right? And then if there is another 1, 7, so it's not possible, right? It's not possible because front and rear will be, okay, will be overflow, okay? According to the previous example, right? So sometimes, right, if you go to the noodle restaurant, right, sometimes you need to use a queue, right, in order to solve for the queue. And if you, okay, if there are only 100 queue, right, from 0, 1 to 100, right, 99, okay, and then if there's someone else to this queue again, 0, 1 queue will be reused. So if you want to implement this kind of queue that we call circular queue, right, you need to do so, right? In the linear queue, right, we have discussed the insertion can be done only one call rear and deletion from front, right? But if you want to represent the circular queue, right, if you have the linear queue like this, and then 54 and 9 has been deleted already, and then suppose you want to insert a new element to the queue, right, from this figure, right? Even there is space available here, but it's not possible. The overflow condition exists. The overflow condition exists because what? The rear has been reached to max minus 1. Right? If you could remember, right? If the rear has been is equal to max minus 1, so it will be overflow. Overflow condition has been detected. So the maximum number of this queue will be only 10, right? If you want to add more queue, right, into this queue, so that's possible. Even there is some 2 space here available. So what can we do? This is a major drawback of the linear queue. What we have to do is we have to use the properties of the feature of the circular queue. How can we implement the circular queue? Right. To resolve this problem, we have 2 conditions. The first one is to shift the element to left. This is the easiest one, right, of implementation. If you have the space left, so you have to shift all this. Shift this to this. Okay, shift to this, right? And then space will be left here. And then you can use, but The drawback of this technique is time consuming. It's very, very time consuming. If you have just only 10 elements, it's okay. But let's think about one mega element. Oh, it suppose once you delete one element, so you have to move almost 1 million elements at a time. So it's not a good idea, right? So we move to the next one, the second option. Is to use the circular queue, right? In the circular queue, the first index comes right after the last index, right? Conceptually, you can think of a circular queue as shown in this figure, right? Q0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? Then the circular queue will be full only when front is equal to 0 and max is equal to max minus 1. Right. A circular queue is implemented in the same manner as a linear queue. The only difference will be the code that perform insertion and deletion operation. For insertion, we now have to check for the following three conditions. If front is equal to 0 and max is equal to max minus 1. So it's full, right? So the circular queue is full, right? Front is the first and rear is the max minus 1. So this circular queue is full, okay, full queue. If rear is not equal to max minus 1, rear is not equal to max minus 1, then rear will be incremented and value can be inserted as figure, this figure. So there is some free space right after the rear pointer, right? So we can insert here. So that it's possible to insert. But once you delete some elements from the queue, right? So the situation will occur like in the figure 8.18, right? Insert. So you can insert. If front is not equal to 0, but rear is equal to max minus 1. So it seems to be that this queue has been full. And then this queue has been deleted as well. So it means that the queue is not full. So you can also insert this element. So if you want to implement insertion in this circular queue, so you can still do that, right? If front is equal to 0 and rear is equal to max, okay, this one, I have already described this. Okay, and then I implement this by using these C programs. You can try this. Okay. And then if you want to delete the queue, right, you can also use this one, right? To check for the underflow, right? If front is equal to minus 1, right? Front is equal to minus 1 and rear is equal to minus 1. Okay, this underflow. And then you get the value and put it into the valve. And then if front is equal to rear, you can reset it to minus 1. But if front is equal to max minus 1, so you have to reset it into front to 0. So you have to round off, right? Round off. Set to 0. But otherwise, if font is not equal to max minus 1, so you can increment font. Okay, this is a way, the same way that you implement the deletion from the circular queue, where you have to increment the font value until the font value is equal to max minus 1. Once the font value is equal to max minus 1, you can reset it to font is equal to 0. And then it will be back to this position. Right, when font is equal to max minus 1, and then when you delete this, and then once you want to, okay. So in this way, you can perform the circular queue in the linear queue, okay? So you can perform circular queue in terms of the linear queue by writing this program. Okay, this is the first types of the queue, right? The second one is the deck. Deck is a list in which the elements can be inserted and deleted at either end. It can be, normally when you talk about the queue, right? Because it is the queue manner, first in, first out, or first come, first serve, right? You need to delete the front elements, right? But for deck, right, it's a special kind of queue, right? It is known as a tail linked list because elements can be added to or removed from either front or back, head or tail, right? However, no element can be added and deleted from the middle. Okay, only front or rear can be deleted. This is called deck, right? A deck is implemented using either a circular array or circular double linked list. Okay, this is what we call deck. This is the second, and this is the third one, the priority queue, right? Sometimes we need to, okay, we have a queue, right? First come, first serve, but we also have the priority, right? If you come later, but you have the priority. Priority means you have the higher order than the others. You need to be accessed first. Sometimes priority queue can be implemented. A priority queue is a data structure in which each element is assigned a priority. The priority of the element will be used to determine the order in which the element will be processed. Okay, I've just told you, right? The highest priority can be accessed or can be processed first. So it's called. The element that has higher priority will be processed first before an element with the lower priority. If there are two elements of the same priority, they will be processed on the first come, first serve basis. Okay, this is priority queue, right? The higher priority will be accessed first. But if there are two elements with the same priority, the one that come first will be accessed first. Okay, this is priority queue. And the last one is the multiple queue, right? When we implement a queue using array, the size of the array must be known in advance. Okay, this is the back of the array. If the queue is allocated less space than frequent overflow condition will be encountered. Okay, this is the way that we are going to resolve the problem of the size of the queue, right? You have to determine the size of the queue first, but once it's not enough, what shall we do? So for multiple queue, we will allocate or we will have the reserved queue, right? Reallocate more space for the array, right? In case we allocate large amount of space for the queue, it results in sheer wastage of memory. Therefore, there lies a trade-off between the frequency of overflow and space allocation. So the solution will be, right? We have multiple queue, or to have more than one queue in the array of sufficient size, we have to declare one more queue, right? Or double queue, right? In order to use as a spare queue, right? Just in case that the queue is overflow, right? So you can use the second queue, right, to solve this. So that's why we call multiple queues. Multiple queues, you have to put S2 here as well. Okay, this is the types of queue that I would like to introduce you. I think that's enough for the first year students. Like we have the near queue, we have the circular queue, right? That is, we use circular queue much, and also priority queue. Priority queue will be used in the operating system course, okay? If you want to define, or if you want to allocate the task to a specified CPU, right? The most or the highest priority of the task will be executed first. Okay, this is a kind of the priority queue. Okay, this is the last topic for today. I think you'll be happy now, right? The application for the queues, I have told you many times about the queue. Queue is very useful in computer science and computer engineering, right? Application, because we have various application of queue. The first one is queue can be used as a waiting list for single shared resource, for example, printer, disk space, or CPU, right? Sometimes the CPU need to access printer or disk or CPU simultaneously, but because we have just only one CPU, so only one resource can be executed. So we have to put it into the waiting list until the first resource has been shared. So you can use this resource. This you have to use queue scheduling. And the next one is queue can be used to transfer data asynchronously. Sometimes data is not necessarily received at the same rate as sent between two processes. Right, I/O buffers like file I/O CPU, right? So queue can be used for transfer data asynchronously. Or sometimes queues are used as buffer on MP3 players or portable CD players. Okay, this is as a buffer. Or queue can be used as a playlist of the jukebox. Or the last one, queue can be used in operating system. In operating system, I have told you many times today that this queue will be important in the operating system class. Okay, for example, for the handling interrupt vector, if you want access to the printer or disk, right, interrupt vector will be used, right? Operating system will send a signal to interrupt the CPU, right? And then if you want to read from a file, right, the executable CPU, we have to stop and then try to open the file. And then in this way, right, we have to put into the operating system, we have to manage this task, right, by using the interrupt vector in order to stop CPU and then go to the interrupt vector of file reading, for example, right? So when programming a real-time system, right, that can be interrupted. So queue will be used. And this is going to be studied into detail in the operating system course, right? I'm not going to talk this into detail. So this is why we need to study queue in data structures. And we also need to study C programming in this curriculum as well, because you have to use it and need to be better, right, in C programming, because you have to use this in operating system course. Okay, and I think this all for today's class, right? And what I need you to do is, because we have many C program example, right? I think we still have time for, okay, I have homework for you, right? You in this chapter, right? I think this is chapter 8, right? There are the C programs, right? Try to copy C program, right, and compile it. Copy C programs, right, for Q. And compile. Okay, this homework is very simple, right? You can just simply copy or type C programs for Q, right? I've just told you, like, linear Q and circular Q. We also have the representation by using array and linked list, right? You can just simply try to copy it and try to compile and see what's happened, right? And try to understand this program. Okay, this is homework. Okay, because I have known that if I teach you, right? And then you go back home and then you don't do anything, right? You will forget the contents of what I have taught you. So in order to make it okay, you need to practice. You need to, the best thing that you can do is after this class, right, you go and then you try to implement, right, writing C program, right, by using array or linked list, right, to implement linear queue or circular queue. This is the things that you have to do. But I know you have many things to do, right? So in order to make sure that you understand this topic theory, I force you, I command you to do this homework, okay? You can just, because we have the, it is a PDF file, right? So you can copy the code from the textbook and then try to understand and compile it, okay? So this is what I want you to do. So in the next week, we are going to have a lab for Q, right? So you can understand about this theory, okay? Is that clear? I hope it's clear. So this is all for today's class. And I would like to check for the class attendance. So you could you please type A to this chat box and then you can leave the room. Okay, I will check for the class attendance. Thank you very much for your attention. And then you can leave the room.